Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today's special dish is healthier version of Shahi Tukda. And now that it's mango season, I will be adding mango flavor to it. So without any delay, let's get started.
To make the rabdi, I've taken 1 cup of milk and I let it boil for quite some time. While our milk is getting boiled, to make Shahi Tukda, I will start roasting the bread slices. For which I will be taking 1 tablespoon of ghee and will be roasting bread slices in that. Ideally in Shahi Tukda, they fry these bread slices. However, we are trying to make a healthier version of it. So we will just roast it in the ghee. You have to slightly roast. So I think one side is done. We will turn it. While our bread slices are hot, we will brush honey on top of it. Ideally in Shahi Tukda, what they do is they immerse these bread slices in sugar syrup. But since we are making the healthier version of it, we will just brush it with honey. So you can see our milk is boiled. Meanwhile, what you have to do is we have to keep moving the malai to the sides. This is how generally rabdi is made. Keep moving the malai to the sides. Now I'm adding 1.5 tablespoon of sugar. Now I'm adding cardamom powder and we'll mix it again. So now you can see our milk is becoming thick. So this is the point where I will be adding paneer. Now a lot of people add other ingredients to make rabdi. I am adding paneer. So I am adding almost 2 to 3 tablespoons of paneer. After adding paneer, make sure that you turn off the flame within 4 to 5 minutes and let it cool completely.
So our rabdi is cooled down completely. Now I'll add mango pulp in this. So I have mango puree. I'll add generous amount of mango pulp in this. And we'll mix this properly. So our mango flavored rabdi is ready. Now let's start doing plating. So first let me put bread slices. So now we'll pour the rabdi mixture. Now we'll garnish this with some pista slices. So our healthy, delicious mango Shahi Tukda is ready to serve.